Hey everyone, here's yet another LEGO NEXO Knights Season 3 set. This is one of the smallest boxed sets in the line. It's called Kingsguard Artillery. This is similar in concept to some of the Year 1 sets that were basically just a vehicle or weapon emplacement for one of the regular dudes, one of the side characters, you know, the massable units of Knightonia who do quite a lot of work and, you know, make a lot of sacrifices, but don't get a lot of screen time because the knights are busy soaking up all the screen time. You know, it's just a regular dude doing his job, trying to defend the lands. And I appreciate that, and I'm glad that they actually put out some sets that include these and include just the side stuff. This has an interesting feature of semi-transformation. It's kind of in between steps right here. You can bring this back, bring the rear wheel back, which actually kind of leans it forward ever so slightly, or you can extend these out to give you basically kind of like a couple of pikes there in the front. I like the look of pretty much all of this, and I think that it actually looks best when it's kind of in between there. It's sticking out a little bit, gives you a little bit of balance, a sense of an anchor in the back. But I don't like the hard plastic wheels. They're just really shiny and they don't seem to really fit in with the look to me. And that also includes the orange pieces they use down in there. They're just a little bit too bright. I'm fine with orange up on top, but these I wish were just a little more muted. They did a good thing with the six stud shooter here, putting a gear back here to actuate that. It makes it look more like the figure who's operating this thing is actually operating it and is actually able to grab the thing that would shoot this off and send those studs flying across the room and underneath a cabinet, I believe. I believe that's where it disappeared. I don't see it. They do give you an extra set of studs as well as a couple spares in addition to that extra set, but it's nice to have something that's close to the figures for controlling things like that. So it doesn't feel quite so much like your huge figure hand is coming in and operating the thing directly. You know, you are bringing in the hand of God to operate something, but at least it's kind of on behalf of the figure, you know, so it makes it a little bit more believable, keeps you a little bit more in the imaginative world, I think. Other than that, not really much to see. We've got a little kind of shield on the front. It doesn't do much. It has a backrest back here, although strangely that's able to rotate side to side, but you know, it's nice that it gets a little bit of ergonomic support. And you know, there's no console or anything, none really needed. Let's take a better look at the figures. The King's Guard on the left is kind of teched up this season. He's got the trans neon orangish red or reddish orange colored armor, which I think is cool. You know, nice to see that in that color rather than just something relatively plain. It stands out and makes it seem like they've gotten an upgrade. On the right is a stone stomper, which is kind of the stone army version of the guy on the left. You know, it's just a regular dude, just a foot soldier. So, you know, it's good to get both of these, and I think it's appropriate to pit them against each other. This weapon here on the right can be used this way, but I think it's also cool to think of using it this way, you know, where it's actually striking with the lightning first. You can kind of decide which of those you prefer. Each of these has print on the back, although much of the print is hidden underneath this armor. They get alternate faces. This face is almost the same as the main one. This face here is different. It's more serious and kind of angry looking, not quite so satisfied with himself at this point. But let me just quickly take off this armor. Oh no, I just lost the head. Oh well, I'll get that back at some point. Just wanted to show you the rest of the print on the back of that torso. Yeah, I think this is a fine set. You know, it's not great. It has nothing about it that's particularly fantastic or that really stands out. It's just something that's inexpensive and allows you to get a very useful battlefield weapon and a couple of just regular figures who are much needed because the heroes, the knights, are used so frequently. And if you collect, I mean, it's very easy to want just, let's say, two of the sets in this line to end up with different bad guys, but then the same knight, you know, twice. just out of two sets if you're just going for the builds that you like. So it's good to be able to get something like this that brings in some of the just regular characters that in the actual universe, you know, make up more closer to the majority of the fighting forces out there. Plus, you know, it's just an inexpensive set in general for fans of the line. That's it for my thoughts on this one. As always, you can feel free to leave your thoughts in a comment down below if you want to. Otherwise, thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.